And as they're fixing this, I'm gonna ask the guys from Ghana to also go to Duke and give him their presentation.
Okay. Good morning, everybody. My name is Kayode Yusuf.
Kayode
Yusuf.
Kayode.
You can shorten it to K. Unfortunately, Toba could not be here. You must cut his name. His name is Olorun Toba Oyeleye. And he should not get a visa, so he does not come. But I have great presentation here. It's not Shona. And we also have another lecturer here, Evan. And we'll be talking about the success of Wikipedia in Nigeria. And please note that it's not the movement. Rather, we're talking about Nigeria because, to the best of my knowledge, the movement is not active in Nigeria. The movement is not active in Nigeria. I would hope that by the time we come home, we can start some activation. And so, I'd like to talk about what I'll call the success of Wikipedia. First is that it's easy to use. In Nigeria, we have a phrase called according to Wikipedia. So that means whenever anyone comes to make a professional presentation, the person most often than not makes the reference to Wikipedia. And that makes it an information bank that people believe in. And then I've heard Aminu talk about their relationship with Orange. In Nigeria, we have four mobile telecom operators. And of these four of them, I'm very sure two of them run offline Wikipedia services. The third one, I am not so sure of them, but I'm very sure of two of them. And what they ask you to do is just to send a text message to a short code. When you send the text message to that short code, you're asked to text the topic that you want to search Wikipedia for. And when you text the topic, you get results like you're actually searching for Wikipedia on your computer. So, I think it's an avenue to have an offline version of Wikipedia there. And in Nigeria, we get a lot of information coming out every day. There's a beehive of news every day, especially in the political arena. And one of the things I've noticed is that when these things happen, I go online to go check for it. And usually, we see constant updating of Wikipedia pages in this aspect. Now, this is one of the mobile operators. This is an advert that came out on Saturday. That is this Saturday that just passed. And this is for Etisalat. Etisalat is a mobile operator in Nigeria. And they have this plan called Click Light, which they made for students. So the fascinating thing about it is this part. So if you subscribe to this service, one of the catch for them is that you will have free access to Wikipedia as a student. So, what are the challenges that we see? A couple of weeks back, I've had this standing argument with people who argue that information from Wikipedia is not being reliable. I had a talk with Asaf and he assured me that that is not completely true. I believe it's not completely true either, but I needed some conviction which he has been able to give to me. And also we have not seen that much localization of articles. Sometimes you see someone in Europe or America write about Nigeria, and probably what they've written is not completely true. So that sort of gives credence to the issue about Wikipedia not being so reliable. But I think the more we get local community to get involved in editing Wikipedia articles, the more that we get local articles correct. Another challenge that I see is that I do not know of any viable local community. Before coming here, I had an online chat with some folks in There are people who are passionate about starting Wikipedia in Nigeria, and this is what they've done. So, as that, before we left Nigeria, we were still in the planning phases, and this has been on for a while. I believe by the time we get back, we'll move away from the planning phase and have something real going on. Future challenges that we see, we may not be as policy tight like the Cameroonians, whereby you have to get permission from governments to run events. You're free to run events as long as they are not events which would eat up public peace and cause issues of national security. So if you don't have such issues, whatever types of events you want to run, you're free to run them. And if you want to invite governments, you're free to invite governments to come. But the challenge that we see is that it's not easy to engage corporate organizations to partner with you for your events. I'll probably have to meet with Aminu after this presentation to get to know how they got Orange to partner with them. But in Nigeria, if you're going to do this, it's going to take a whole lot from you, I assure you. So what are the future opportunities that we see? Nigeria is becoming the beacon of news. We're going to be having our general elections in a couple of months. And because of this, every day there are news coming up in the political sphere. So what this means for Wikipedia is that a lot of pages can be updated daily. And certainly more people are getting online via mobile phones, via fiber access, and the likes. And of course, people are willing to create articles. A couple of weeks ago, we had the former central bank governor being coronated as the emir of Kano. And it was a very controversial coronation. So I went online to check. And now when I went online, I did not go to Google to check. I went to Wikipedia to check. But I wanted to see what Wikipedia had to say about this event that happened about 2 hours ago. And believe you me, I did not just see the story of how he got coronated, I saw the history of all the emirs of Kano. So people certainly are willing to create articles. We just need to engage them and encourage them to create more articles on Wikipedia. And then, like I said the other night, there's a young team of people who are very ready and willing to work on this. As a matter of fact, they've actually been working on this even before I got involved in them. They were the ones who created the Wiki page I showed you earlier, and by the time we get back, we're going to look for a way to engage them and make sure that we make a success out of this. I'll be better call these future plans than future opportunities. Now, people have access to mobile phones, and the mobile networks are pushing Wikipedia to those who have access to these mobile phones. But there are a lot of academic institutions who are in the rural areas who do not have access to mobile phones. A lot of them have access to computers because when politicians want to campaign, these are some of the things that they use to catch the communities. You give them computers, and these people do not even usually use these computers. So you're looking at distribution of offline versions of Wikipedia to these schools, because usually they don't even use the computers, not because of having access to the internet. And they would not even have access to the internet in any recent time. So if they can have access to offline versions of Wikipedia, I think it's going to do them a whole lot of good than having the computers sitting and gathering dust. We're still looking at activation of land. In Nigeria, we have a lot of cultural sites. We have a lot of museums. We have a lot of monuments, which are gradually being forgotten. We believe that if we can activate GLAM, it's going to be a good thing for the community because we're going to be preserving our culture. And then we're also going to be looking at collaborating with other communities in West Africa. We have collective cultures with the Ghanaians, with those in Togo, in Benin. We have collective cultures and there will be things that we could do together. So with this, I think I've come to the end of my presentation. I say thank you for listening to me.
Remarks, additions, questions, whatever you have. Yes, sir.
Okay. I'm Raphael from Ghana.
My question, in your submission, you talked about Wikipedia being source of information or an information bank in Nigeria. But then you also raise some issues with respect to its reference. In Ghana, we also have such a critical issue that in most of the universities, if you are doing your project work or your field work, and then you do citations or references, and then it's Wikipedia, they get settled out. You don't even take time to go and find out whether or not that is well cited, even on the Wikipedia site. They have this very perceived conception that it is lazy students who use Wikipedia. So I don't know if our situation is quite different from yours, because initially you said it's a reference bank, meaning it's more credible and more accepted. In Ghana, and in other places, it's accepted, but when you go to most of the leading universities, their professors and lecturers have fabricated to Wikipedia.
Okay. Thank you, Raphael. Let me speak out to him.
You know how I do this? I will take a group of questions, but please be precise on your question so that we don't get lost along the whole comments, so that we can present to them and then they can answer.
Just to add to what he said.
Okay.
Yeah, just to add to what he said. I think the main problem with our lectures not accepting things like this is because people who analyze the things that are on Wikipedia, say, for instance, I create an article that about fufu, right, and I reference it to a Ghanaian university or a group of lecturers in Ghana that created that fufu machine, right? People go and change the whole thing and attribute it to their country. That is the problem that we're having, because you can't get authentic information anymore. People vandalize pages just like that, and they have access to that. So I think that was the one it was saying earlier.
Now, to your first question, back in Nigeria, I think reverse is the case. If you're going to write a project thesis, usually you expect to see a reference from a reliable source as Wikipedia. So, the issue of it not being reliable is not coming from the academic scale. It's coming rather from a group of enlightened guys who think if just anyone has access to elite information, then there's a very good possibility that that person is going to put information from their own point of view, which might not actually be the accurate information. So, yes, Wikipedia is a data bank which is very much being used in Nigeria, but the people who think it is not being reliable are very minute, and I think if we're able to convince those people that it's not as error prone as they think it is, then I think we would not have a problem with that.
I have a problem with that. I personally think it's not a problem about convincing people, but it's about we making our stuff on Wikipedia authentic. In the sense that when you write articles that are correct, nobody should have a chance to go change it because of his or her own preference.
Okay, now,
that's what the problem is.
The point here now is not whether your articles are correct or not. It's the point that you are an engineer and you're writing something about your knowledge about a medical ailment. So naturally, someone would not want to believe you because you're an engineer. So it's not the point whether your article is correct or not. It's just a mindset that if anyone can edit an article on Wikipedia, then it's just as good as saying it's not coming from a reliable source.
You know why we trust books? I just want to clarify something. You know why we trust our books?
Why
we trust our books? Books.
Okay, yeah.
It's because it's written by one person and approved by a group of people. Okay. And it doesn't have to be changed unless another person writes a version of that same book. You get it? And it has to be approved by a group of people again. On Wikipedia, anybody can just edit an article. Even if the article that was written by an authentic person. That's why I have. You get what I mean?
Okay, I understand.
So it's not about you writing it from your sense of view that is really correct, but the fact that even if it's right, somebody can just go
and change what you're using. Right, I think we'll leave that for the guys at Wikimedia Foundation to servant.
Okay, I'm going to give it 2 cents to Misani. And is there anyone who wants to have a comment or a question after said Misani? Okay, say David, then say Asaf, and then I close from there because the time is.
I don't know when I was knighted. I didn't follow the discussion that happened between you two guys, but maybe you'll clarify it later. I think, however, that you are correct. It is an issue that we're also fighting with in South Africa. The perception that because Wikipedia can be edited by anyone, therefore is not a reliable source of reference. For us, especially in South Africa, it's really with academics in universities who will actually mark students down because they use Wikipedia. And I did go through that while I was in university. I got heavily marked down because I used Wikipedia. I didn't expect it. On the next one, I used Wikipedia. I used the references that were in Wikipedia, and I wasn't marked down. So I went to the professor and I said, this is the same thing I did for the previous assignment. You marked me down. The second assignment, you don't mark me down. I'm using the same references that are coming off Wikipedia. And he was flabbergasted. He just didn't know what to say to me. So it's a question of perception. It's one that we need to find. But I do have a question for you guys in Nigeria. What is the level of involvement that you get when you organize events in Nigeria, and what percentage of female participants come to your events?
Okay. And before that, can you pass the microphone to Sir Douglas, and then after that, you pass it to Sir Asaf, so that we can be read more into the questions. And if you don't mind, I can go to the question and then
your team catch them.
Okay.
Yeah,
if you're
going
to ask a question,
do so. Oh. Laura is mine. It's just a comment on the accuracy of written sources, the accuracy of published sources in in comparison to something, say, Wikipedia, which is collaborative. A couple of years ago, they did a study on the accuracy of Wikipedia in comparison to Encyclopedia Britannica. And they found that Wikipedia was marginally more accurate than Encyclopedia Britannica. Actually, it was a better source, on average. I mean, obviously, it's a big place, so it's riddled with inaccuracy. But then again, so is Encyclopedia Britannica. And I mean, this whole concept that knowledge is only truly knowledge when it is written down does, to some extent, have to be questioned. I mean, like even in the Western world, where this concept in many ways spawned from, in the Greeks, celebrated for their classical writing, popularizing literature. In an ancient Greece, if a written source wasn't nearly as reliable as a spoken source, and the reason for that was precisely the reason that you give as evidence why it's reliable source. It's because anyone can write something. Anyone. And the nice thing about something like Wikipedia is because it's peer-reviewed. So for example, your book is written by, say, an academic. Yes, true, he stakes his reputation by saying that. But often, what a person might say might be a mistaken, or it's got a political agenda behind it. And there are far fewer people peer-reviewing that as a written source. Whereas in Wikipedia, real-time, the peer review mechanism tends to be much stronger. I'm not saying it's always the case. Is Wikipedia more or less reliable than other sources? Obviously, that depends. Indications are might be sometimes more reliable. So it's not an open and such a case. So I wouldn't dwell on it too much. That's my comment.
I have a question. Your presentation seemed to focus on getting more people to use the existing knowledge on Wikipedia, and you mentioned localizing articles and making sure they are, for example, articles about Nigeria, about Nigerian culture, are accurate. You didn't explicitly, at least, mention your own efforts towards that end. Do you personally edit to make this happen, or are you in touch with active editors in Nigeria in your efforts to get others to use Wikipedia?
Okay, so I'll start with the first question. The question was, how large are events, right? So events are pretty large depending on how you organize them. And usually if it's a free event, you can ensure that, and if you do good advertisements online, I'm sure that people definitely attend. The percentage of female participants, it varies. If it's IT events, you might get very few female participants.
I was specifically asking with the activities that you guys organize. How many, when if you are organizing, say, a function for women regarding, how many people actually come?
Okay.
For those that come, how many of them are female?
Okay. Now, in Nigeria, we really do not have a movement yet. So, like I said, perhaps now nothing has been going on. So, I really cannot talk about any events because I do not know any. And probably when we make tests, we can ask this question at the end and you can get a very simple answer. And back to Asaf's question. Yeah, sometimes I go online to search for some things, and when I do not see, or when the answers I see are not they are not what I expect to see, I usually buy it to edit. So yes, I edit. And I'm in contact with at least two editors that I know. And these are the guys who have been planning to start in Nigeria. And I believe by the time we get back home, we should start in full force. So yes, I know at least two editors.
I hope everyone is answered, but what I gathered is there's no chapter in India, right? How do you say you don't organize any chapter?
There has not been any official Wikimedia group that I know of. So nothing has been on ground as at now.
Anyway, in light of this, I would like to record the I would like to ask you.
Thank you very much.